Good afternoon, everyone. Today I am here to present our presentation on the topic computerization push down automata. Here me Tushar and Trisha Kundu are here to present our slide view. Trisha,
yes,
will you start now?
As we know, push down automata is a very important topic in theory of computation. It has a read-only input tab and input alphabet and infinite state control and a set of final state and initial state as in case of FA. A pushdown automata consists of seven tuples, as we can see here. The first one is Q, that is the set of state, it is denoted by Q. The second one is the set of inputs involved, that is denoted by sigma, and the next one is the set of pushdown symbol, that is denoted by tau, and the initial state, that is denoted by Q naught, and the pushdown symbol, called the initial symbol of the pushdown probe, denoted by Z naught, and a set of final state is denoted by capital F, and a transition function sigma is here. Next slide, please.
Okay. Next slide. Definition, yes, of pushdown automata. Here are some definition which we have
next
given.
Next slide.
Okay.
Next.
Configuration.
Yes.
Trisha?
Yes, yes. Okay. Now we hear the definition of configuration. A configuration of PAM is a triple where Q equals to current state of the final control and W equals to unused input, and alpha consists of push down. The left symbol is the topmost symbol. So we go to next slide.
Okay.
With the example of pushdown automata.
Example of pushdown automata, construct a PDA for language of this given value, where W is reserved for W, of W. In this process, we have several steps which are mentioned here. In step 1, on receiving 0, or one, keep on pushing it on top of a stack without going to the next state. Step 2, on receiving an element C, move the next state without making any changes in stack. Step 3, on receiving an element, check if symbol scanned is one, and top of a stack also contain one, or if symbols scan is zero and top of stack also contain zero, then pop the element from the top of the stack, else move to the dead state. Keep on repeating step 3 until the string becomes empty. In step 4, check if symbol scan is dollar and stack does not contain any element, then move to final state, else move to the dead state. Odd length palindrome. Here are two examples which we are giving to support our answer. Next slide.
Yes. Okay. Yes, here we can see the three state of this language. First one is Q0, second one Q1, and the final state is Q2. And Q0 is the starting state. So we can see that when the input symbol is 1 and the topmost symbol of the put of the PDS is 0, then we took the one into our pushdown automata stack, and following those rules, and when we get the C, we go to the next state Q1, And when we get input one and one on our topmost symbol, then we pop one. And when we get zero as an input symbol and zero as our topmost symbol, we again pop it. After that, when we get nothing in this string, we go to the state Q0, as we mentioned that it is the final state. So the string is accepted here. Next slide.
Okay. Examples. Construct push down automata for given language. Construct PDA for language L. For this given value, where 0 to the power n to the power 1 n and 1 to the power m. N is greater than equal to 1, m is greater than equal to 1, m is greater than equal to n plus 2. Approach used in this PDA. Yes, sorry for that. Step 1. On receiving 0, push it into a stack. On receiving 1, ignore it and go to next state. Step 2. On receiving 1, ignore it and go to next state. Step 3. On receiving 1, pop a 0 from top of a stack and go to next state. Step 4. On receiving 1, pop a 0 from top of a stack. If a stack is empty, on receiving 1, ignore it and go to next state. In state 5, on receiving 1, ignore it. If input is finished, then go to last state. To support our example, we have given some examples here below. Can we go to next slide, Trisha?
Yes.
Okay. Hand over to you.
Here, yes. Here we can see the grammar has five state. Q0 is the starting state, I mean initial state, and Q5 is the final state here. As we see, when our input symbol is zero, and Z0 is the topmost symbol in PDS, we store it into our PDS. Okay, then next, when we get 0, when we get 1 as our input and 0 as topmost symbol, we took 0 in the PDS and go to the next state Q1. When in state Q1, when we get symbol input symbol 1 and our topmost symbol 0, we again hit 0 and go to the state Q2. And in state Q2, when we get our input symbol 1 and our topmost symbol is 0, we pop it and go to the state Q3. And in case Q3, when we get our input symbol 1 and topmost symbol 0, we again pop it and go to the state Q4. Q3, when we input symbol is 1 and our topmost symbol is Z0, and then we Z0, and we go to the state Q5. What is the which is the final state of our grammar? So, to this language, we can accept the same number of two elements like 30 and 31, which is take input to our language algorithm. So next slide.
Okay. Here are few questions which we are giving for related to our topics. Thanks, everyone.
Tushar, next slide. Here is the another question of our topic, Gustav Automata. And next we do to get question. Next slide, please.
Okay. Here are few get question related to our topic. Next slide.
So that's all, and that is the end.
Thank you, Trisha and Tushar. Good. Thank you very much. Okay, let's stop recording. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.